This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. So we've talked about the special angles, which are the angles on the quadrants, like 0 degrees, 90 degrees, 180 degrees, etc. And we've talked about the special angles that come from the 30-60-90 triangle, so that's the 30 degrees and the 60 degrees, and we've talked about the 45-45-90 degree triangle, so the special angle there is 45 degrees. There happens to be a cool pattern for the sines and cosines of the special angles in the first quadrant, including 0 degrees and 90 degrees. Those aren't in the first quadrant, but they lie on the quadrants. So what you see here are the sines and the cosine for 0 degrees, 30, 45, 60, and 90 degrees. You could figure these out yourself each time. But here's how you can get this pattern yourself without just memorizing, saying, I don't see the pattern right now. The main thing I remember is that the sine of 0 is 0. So the sine of 0 degrees is 0. It doesn't matter if you have 0 degrees or 0 radians, by the way. But here is how you get these numbers. Little trick. You start off with the square. You're going to make all these fractions with a 2 in the denominator. Okay? And then you're going to, in the numerator, that you're all going to have square roots. So I've got the square root of something all over 2. All of these are the square root of something over 2. Same thing is going to happen over here. It's going to be the square root of something over 2. 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 And square root of something over 2. And here's what you have to remember. If you're doing it for sine, you're going to start with 0 and just count up. All right, so watch what goes under the square root. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. And if you simplify each of these, you get what I have right here. Because the square root of 0 is 0, and 0 divided by 2 is simply 0. The square root of 1 is 1, so this will give you the 1 half. Square root of 2 over 2, that's already simplified, and so square root of 3 over 2. And the last one, square root of 4, that's 2, right? And 2 over 2 does equal 1. So this little pattern gives you those values. Now, it goes backwards for the cosine. So it goes 4, 3, 2, 1, 0, or start at 0 at the bottom. Or what you could say is these just go in reverse order. So look for the sine. Notice for the sine it goes 0, 1 half, square root of 2 over 2, square root of 3 over 2, and 1. You just take those values and go backwards. So start at the bottom, 1, then square root of 3 over 2, square root of 2 over 2, etc. And so that's the little pattern. So how could you get the pattern again? All right, so if you wanted to make this chart up, let's say you're taking a test and you just feel like having all those values without having to figure it out each time, you could do this. You could say, well, I'm just going to do, I know the sine of 0 is 0, so that's the key to start off with. Square root of 0 over 2, square root of 1 over 2, square root of 2 over 2, square root of 3 over 2, square root of 4 over 2, and then if you just simplify each of these, you're going to get exactly the sine of all those. So this is going to give you a 0, 1 half, square root of 2 over 2, square root of 3 over 2, and the last one is going to be 1. And for the cosine, you just reverse the order. 1, square root of 3 over 2, square root of 2 over 2, 1 half, and 0. And then you've got those 5 values already set. All right, so that's something that's just kind of interesting. There is a pattern. I've never memorized it myself. I just always figure it out each time for each problem. That works for me. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.